All right, good evening, everybody. So glad you could be here with us tonight. We have the third and fourth graders, obviously, of Cowern. And all of our songs today have to do around the book, Wangari's Trees of Peace. Okay? So this story actually takes place in Kenya. So our first song is from Kenya. It is in Swahili. Hope that you enjoy. Wangari's Trees of Peace. This is a true story from Africa. Wangari lives under an umbrella of green trees in the shadow of Mount Kenya in Africa. She watches the birds in the forest where she and her mother go to gather firewood for cooking. And she helps harvest the sweet potatoes, sugarcane, and maize from the rich soil.
Yeah. Wangari shines in school, and when she grows tall like the trees in the forest, she wins a scholarship to study in America. 6 years later, her study is over, Wangari returns to her Kenya home, and sees a change.
What has happened, she wonders. Where are the trees? Wangari sees women bent from hauling firewood miles and miles from home. She sees barren land where no crops grow. And where are the birds?
Thousands of trees have been cut down to make room for buildings, but no one planted new trees to take their place. Will all of Kenya become a desert? She wonders as her tears fall.
Wangari thinks about the barren land. I can begin to replace some of the lost trees here in my own backyard, one tree at a time. She starts by planting 9 seedlings.
Next. Watching the seedling take root, given Wangari the idea to plant more, to start a farm for baby trees, a nursery. In an open place, she plants row after row of the tiny trees.
Next, Wangari convinces the village woman that planting trees is a good thing. She gives each money silently. Our lives will be better when we have trees again. You'll see, we are planting the seeds of hope. Spread out the village, planting tiny trees and long rows, like a green belt stretching over the land. The government men laugh. Women can't do this, they say. It takes trained foresters to plant trees. The women ignore the laughter and keep planting. Good luck.
Wangari pays them a small amount of Small amount of each seedling still living after 3 months, their first earning ever. Weird travelers like wind rustling through leaves about the green returning of Wangari's village. Soon other women in other villages and towns and cities of Kenya are planting long rows of seeds, seedlings too, but the cutting continues.
Wangari stands tall as an oak to protect the old trees still remaining. We need a park more than we need an office tower. The government men disagree and Wangari blocks their way, so they hit her with clubs. They called her a troublemaker and put her in jail. And still she stands tall. Right is right, even if you're alone.
But Wangari is not alone. Talk of the trees spreads all over Africa, like ripples in Lake Victoria. More women hear the talk and plant even more seedlings in longer and longer rows. The seedlings take root and grow tall until there are over 30 million trees where there were none.
The umbrellas of green in Kenya returns women walk tall, their back straight, for now they can gather firewood closer to home. The land is no longer barren. Sweet potatoes, sugar canes, and maize grow again in the rich red earth.
The whole world hears of Wangari's trees and of her army of women who planted them. And if you were to climb to the very top of Mount Kenya today, you would see the millions of trees growing below you and the green Wangari brought back to Africa.
Thank you.
All right, we hope you've enjoyed Wangari's Trees of Peace. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you also to Suburban Community Channels. They're here to record tonight's program. Your students are going to go back to their classrooms, grab their coats and everything, and you can pick them up there. Thank you again for coming.